What's going on, guys? Welcome back to a brand new terrifying video. As you can see, I am fully pimped out, ready to go with my scary story outfit, shirt, and hat. I know I am not consistent with my outfits, okay? I know I'm wearing a different outfit in all the thumbnails, right? And you know, it's kind of annoying because I know like I get the pose just right in every thumbnail. I'm wearing the shirt, I'm wearing the hat every day, doing the same thing, but I always forget to wear the shirt and the hat for the actual video. But today, guys, hey, what's up? Got my shirt, got my hat, we're ready to go. Before we get started on today's scary story, I want to give a quick thank you to the sponsor of today's video, Alliance Heroes of the Spire. This game has been massively breaking into the top mobile charts, and it's only getting more popular from here, guys. Almost 400 unique heroes that you can combine in over 1,000 different ways on the battlefield. Now that's impressive. Two cool game modes, fighting to the death against crazy giant bosses, as we seem to like in all RPG games, or battle real people, or even your best friends in a PvP mode. And not to mention really awesome combat between different guilds. Play alone, play with your friends, play with your mom. Seriously, guys, I can talk about Alliance for hours, but it's better you go check it out yourself. Oh, here's another little bonus for you guys. If you download Alliance using my referral link in the description, you guys can get a bonus of 50,000 gold and 50 gems to spend right now on your adventures. So if you guys want to download an awesome game that you can play anytime, anywhere, and with anyone, click the link in the description and download Alliance today. And with that said, guys, let's get on with today's scary story. It's a cold and dark night at the cocktail bar. A woman sips on her drink. Tap. She puts it down. Phew. Everyone always leaves me, and nobody loves me. But then, a man approaches her. Hey, cutie, wanna have a drink with me? The woman looks at the man.
I can't.
Why not?
Guys always leave me after I drink with them. It's so strange. At first, all they tell me is that they like me. And then...
Ugh, I know. I may be a guy myself, but even I think guys are seriously two-faced. They tell their girlfriends not to drink while they themselves get wasted at every party they can. It's so stupid. Not gonna lie, this guy's pretty smooth. Let's see if he actually gets some action tonight.
The
woman sighs. The man smirks.
Damn, dude, yo, if this actually works, I gotta be taking some notes.
That was a joke. Calm thyself.
Well, what about a drink with me? I like a girl who knows how to drink.
The
woman says nothing, but the look on her face says something else. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Blackout, story and art by Park Mingyung. The next day, at the Hotel Sunrise? Sunset?
The Hotel Sun! We're gonna just leave it at that.
Yo, so they ended up in a hotel. Okay, yo, our boy, he's got his moves.
Ugh. My head. How much did I drink last night?
The woman wakes up and holds her head.
Huh?
Just then, she looks at her arm and notices an overwhelming amount of what looks to be bruises. She says nothing but examines the bruises on her arms.
Sangil, last night...
She turns to the man. However, oh my gosh, he one-upped her. Clearly, he was just in it for the one-night stand. And potentially beat her, dude. What the...
The woman says nothing as she sits in the empty bed.
Again. The next day, at a coffee shop.
This is already the fourth time that a guy has disappeared after I drink with him.
It appears the woman is sitting down with her friend.
Did you have another blackout yesterday?
Yeah. I can't remember a thing. And I must have run into something because I'm all covered in bruises.
Her friend doesn't say anything.
I know I can get a bit rough when I'm drunk, but still, is it so bad that guys have to disappear without saying a word?
Do you really not remember anything?
Yeah.
Tap! She puts the drink down.
All right. Get up. Let's go.
I'll help you remember. It seems her friend has come up with some kind of plan, but what that'll be, we have yet to find out. Later, we arrive at what looks to be an abandoned warehouse.
Where is this?
Careful. It's dark.
They head down a few stairs.
Clunk!
They reach the basement of the building. We see a man sitting at a desk with a computer.
Say hi. This is my boyfriend.
Hi.
He's going to help you recover your memories from last night.
Okay, like, it's nice that you have a boyfriend and it's nice that you're reaching out to help her, but what's with the setup? Like, your boyfriend is living in the basement of an abandoned warehouse with just a computer and a desk and a fridge way in the back? I just got a couple of questions to ask him and the FBI may or may not be involved.
He can help me? Remember what happened?
It's a kind of hypnotism. Now, this way.
He beckons over to a chair for the girl to sit down in.
Relax. Just close your eyes while I count to three. The memories may appear extremely vivid, so don't let them surprise you. Now, let's begin. One, two.
The girl closes her eyes.
Three.
He snaps his fingers, and everything goes dark.
Nothing better pop out right now, otherwise, man, I'm about to...
Huh, we hear some huffs and huffs. Tap, tap, tap. We hear someone running in the background. Huh, a man runs.
Okay, it's the dude from last night who I guess, you know, had the one night stand, but looks like something else happened.
He's holding his arm, bleeding.
Ugh, damn it.
He clenches his bleeding arm.
Man, what's your problem? You crazy bitch.
He takes a minute to catch his breath.
Who?
Just then, a voice calls out.
Me?
The girl pops out from around the corner. It doesn't look like she's dangerous or anything, but the man's face says otherwise.
Oh my gosh!
Dude, look at that. She just looks so innocent, but then— Oh my gosh! Joker smile.
Bad.
I mean, yeah, the smile's creepy, but she's still kinda cute.
8 out of 10 would smash. With a baseball bat, because if I don't, she's gonna stab me with that knife.
And then, we hear the man scream as he probably meets his imminent doom.
Well, that's what you get for trying to do a one-night stand with my girl.
Lesson learned, guys. Don't ever try to play this girl, okay?
Challenge accepted.
Flash. The girl wakes up.
She clenches her head. She jumps up. This can't be. I...
Suyeon, are you okay?
No. How could I?
I'm sure you don't want to believe it, but that's the truth.
You said guys always disappear the night after you drink with them, right?
Well, the reason is...
Lies! Don't lie to me!
The woman screams out in denial.
Lies. It's all lies.
Her friend tries to comfort her, looking to her boyfriend for help.
Calm down, Suyeon.
Calm thyself.
You're too shocked right now to accept it, but don't worry. We'll help you.
So, just do as we say, okay?
Suyeon continues to breathe heavily, but doesn't say anything, still in shock.
Clunk!
The door flings open. Her friend has returned, alone.
Man, when she started saying it's all lies, I seriously thought we were busted.
Same here, haha.
For a second, I wondered if we had screwed up.
What the heck? Dude, they, what?
You didn't make any mistakes, right? In the hypnosis?
Of course. I made it as violent as I could. I turned her into an innocent-looking psychopath who murders guys whenever she gets drunk. Haha. Man, I can't believe how easy she was to hypnotize. I guess since we created those memories for her, this is like memory manipulation, huh?
The two laugh at their accomplishment, getting ready to pour a drink.
Now we'll get her to pay us, just like we planned. We'll say we need some money to help clean up after her mess, and throw in a bit of blackmail.
Clink. Their wine glasses touch, toasting to their deceit.
Damn, dude, talk about class A horrible friends.
But her arms and body were all covered in bruises. What really happened to her, huh?
Ah, didn't I tell you? Before, she had a really bad case of dating abuse.
Oh my gosh, dude, holy, is this actually truth? Hopefully it is. I mean, well, now that I said that, hopefully it's not, because I wouldn't wish for any girl to get beaten up like this.
Dating abuse?
Yeah, you know, bad guys who hit women. Basically, she met the wrong guy once and ended up getting beaten up really badly.
Wham!
We see a depiction of a guy clearly abusing Suyeon.
After that, because of the trauma, whenever she gets drunk, she clings to guys until they beat her up.
We see another depiction of a man grabbing her by the hair and punching her as she begs him not to hurt her.
What the heck, dude? There are actually people like this, you know? That's a sad thing.
Anyway, I'm surprised that she doesn't remember that she did all that to her own body. The poor thing.
We see a flashback to Suyeon shuddering. She steps down the street by herself. She peers out at a convenience store.
The saddest part, we see an image of all the beer and alcohol, is that she's a severe alcoholic. So there's no way she'll ever stop drinking.
And we can clearly see Suyeon looking blindly at the alcohol while the cashier in the back just wonders what the heck is this girl thinking.
Man, I hope Sangil didn't beat her up too badly yesterday.
Sangil?
Oh, so they're... Oh, man. Dude, they bamboozled her!
Ah, right. Sangil. Give him a call. I told him to lay low for a while, but now he's not even answering his phone.
Jeez, what a guy. He's probably out partying with the money he took from her wallet last night.
Ring.
The boyfriend calls Sangil's phone. Another flashback. We see Suyeon sitting at a fountain by herself. She's drinking alone, with several beers right next to her. We see her face. And then, her eyes shift. What the heck happened?
Okay, I don't know what that was all about.
He hears the phone ringing. However, the sound is a lot closer than they thought.
Huh?
The ringing continues.
Wait, Sangil's here?
Man, why didn't he freaking tell us?
They look over to the other side of the room.
Hey,
why is he?
Could he be?
The ringing continues. Sk, sk.
All right, dude, well, you see the ska? That's your cue. You know what's gonna happen.
They pull the blanket where the sound is coming from, and then...
Oh my goodness!
He's dead.
Dead as a doorknob. Dead by daylight. That's a fun game, but not related.
Just then, clunk! The two of them turn around.
Suyeon.
Suyeon has bursted through the door. She says nothing, but then...
How did you know?
What?
She looks at them.
And then, oh snap!
Oh gosh, she's angry.
I said...
How did you know?
Ah!
The two of them scream out in fear.
Oh my gosh, dude, and there is Suyun. Dude, just popping out of nowhere with a knife. Oh my gosh, wait a minute, what is this? Ah, I don't want to do that again. What does all this mean? Does that mean she really is the murderer? We see drops of blood. And then, a flashback again. We see the beer cans, but we don't see Suyun. Clank, one of the cans rolls away. And then, we see a close-up on one of the cans. Zero beer, no alcohol. And that's the end. Holy! That was a little bit confusing to take in at first, but I think I got it. Basically, correct me if I'm wrong, but she was not an alcoholic. She's just a plain old killer, but her friend tried to manipulate her because her friend thought that she was an alcoholic, right? So her friend thought, oh, she doesn't remember anything. We can manipulate her. But secretly, did she not know? Her friend, Suyun, knows everything, and she remembered everything. And she kills everything. Everyone. Oh my gosh, dude, talk about a scam backfiring. So Suyun is just a plain old hot murderer. Wow. But yeah, lesson learned. What is the lesson? Just don't date anybody, okay? No. Don't drink with anybody. You know what, guys? Just don't even go out. That's your safest bet right there. And while you guys are at home relaxing in the comfort of your safety, be sure to download Alliance and play it today. Seriously, guys, if you do like mobile RPGs and you do want to get something to play when you're bored, click the link in the description. It does help out my channel a lot. Oh man, I don't know what to think about this story, dude. Wow, what a twist of events. I will say this though, one good thing to come out of this whole thing, nobody's an alcoholic, right? Let me know what you guys thought about this story down below in the comments. As always, thank you guys so much for watching, and until next time, I will see you guys in the next video. Good night.